It's wonderful news. Wonderful. People are really anxious to get back to normal.
Cape Coral is about to take a huge step back to normal. The city says you'll be able to hit the sand at the Yacht Club Beach next Friday, November 10th. NBC2's Rachel Whalen is live at the Yacht Club right now. And Rachel, a lot of people waiting for this one, especially now that the weather is getting nicer and season is about to be here.
That's absolutely right. And a lot of the sand you see behind me is actually brand new. We watched crews today work to refill this beach. That's what the city was waiting for the okay on before making this big announcement. We met Alan Vinoy earlier this month when we still didn't know when Cape Coral's only beach would open.
If you had somebody in the city that wanted this open, this could be open this time next week.
But after breaking the news with him today,
you got it.
We saw a whole different side of Alan.
The chain link fence is coming down on the 10th, so maybe I will vote for the mayor after all.
The city announced the Cape Coral Yacht Club Beach is reopening next Friday. They were waiting on a permit from the Army Corps of Engineers before crews can finish replacing the sand on the beach. Well, today we saw crews doing just that.
I'm hoping they can enlarge it a little bit because, yeah, it's way too small for, you know, what's people here now.
This has been a long time coming. This beach was destroyed more than a year ago after Hurricane Ian. Back in February, more than 600 people signed a petition urging the city to hurry up and take this chain link fence down.
Just to have it open, it'll be packed. You watch the first day it's open, it'll be packed.
My next ex-wife could well be under that palm tree by the 11th.
What can we say? This beach means a lot to people. I asked the city what's next for the rest of the Cape Coral Yacht Club. They said they should have more answers by next week. So you can count on NBC2 to stay on top of that. For now, I'm reporting at the Cape Coral Yacht Club, Rachel Whalen, NBC2.
Certainly.